predictive maintenance component of the analysis use case. As Stathis already mentioned, in this use case, we examined specifically the crosshead bearing defects caused by slow steaming. Despite of the substantial reduction of fuel consumption, slow steaming results in less efficient engine lubrication. So some quite common structural defects caused by slow steaming refer to crosshead bearing. Given the high cost of inspection, this scenario is well suited to showcase the added value of an efficient predictive maintenance strategy based on the modern machine learning and statistical models. So in our case, both supervised and unsupervised models were utilized along with some statistical metrics such as rolling weight, permutation, entropy. Also, we tried to exploit patterns both for point and collective anomalies as we address that challenge as anomaly detection task. The work done in the second half of the project, depicted with green color, includes the introduction of a complementary model in the ML stack and the creation of data skipping in the process of retrieving the data from the object store. Also, we have utilized all of the 20 vessels instead of the 6 that we used during the first half of the project. Furthermore, we are working on exploring some approaches trying to denote the specific cylinder on which of the engine when alert is produced without yet significant findings. So this will not be part of this demo. Also, it should be mentioned that our research was presented at the 23rd IEEE, the National Conference of Intelligent Transportation Systems. So we will not elaborate with details of the results of which model, as we did during the midterm review. In the next slides, the pipeline is depicted and the data models that were used. Firstly, it is presented the pipeline of the training process, where the main ML models are depicted, like LSTM1 classes, VM, etc. So the outcome of the training process are the trained, let's say, models which are saved in order to be loaded for the prediction on the unseen data. In this slide, we focus on the pre-processing step of the pipeline. We'll use various methods of for the pre-processing. Most of them were utilized in order to remove the noise and smooth the time series, making the model capable of generalizing better on the unseen data. Of course, some of the steps were applied specifically on some models and not all of them. For example, the resample was utilized only for the LSTM model. The results of the models at month 18 and 36 are in the slide. In both cases, quality assessment is applied and vessel number 5 was used as a test set. The red vertical lines are the dates of the defect in the vessel, while the blue lines denote the outcome of the models. As an alert threshold, the average number of the utilized models were used in both cases. So the extra information gained by the extra 14 vessels optimizes somehow the model. The main difference is that we could finally avoid misclassifying the false positive where the green arrow is pointing, but we still miss the defect where the red arrow is pointing. Furthermore, as we said, the data skipping tool was leveraged in this use case. The performance optimization results regarding the usage of data skipping comes as a result of filtering based on the daytime. Having in mind that data skipping depends on the way that the data set is partitioned, the distribution of the data, and the query is issued. Also, the size of the data is a key parameter for proving the utility of data skipping. In our case, it's not a huge data set, but we applied data skipping both and attested both for the training and the prediction process. So the training process, the result of the training of the application of data skipping, the training process are depicted on the first table. And for the prediction process, one that we will demonstrate, the impact of the data skipping is quite good. And for every day, only a history of 10 days is needed to be fed in the ML stack. So the results of the data skipping usage for each of the models is both of them came from the data skipping native analytics tool. Regarding our use case, some key features of the implementation are that we used Spark version 3. Mini object store was used, where two Parquet files for each vessel, not the three of them as started said, but only the vessel and the main engine was useful for us. These files were stored to the partition based on the daytime column. And this approach concludes with 8,000 objects in total. The data skipping was leveraged for optimizing the performance of predictive maintenance, and for that case, the min max indexer was from the data skipping tool was utilized. The key parts that we should prove in our case, are the data models, the data skipping, and the connection to the Linux skill database. As through the Linux skill database, the alerts are populated to the NAOS monitor platform. So we're going to demonstrate the prediction of an alert as depicted in the diagram during the first days of 2018. We are presenting the recorded demo as it takes some time to run it live. Okay, let's start the video. So you will notice that we have fast forward some of the parts from the demo. So at the upper right part of the screen, we can have a look at the MinIO object store. We can see the partition data of the NAOS dataset. And then we can also see the index bucket where the meta index and data skipping are stored. Furthermore, after that, again at the upper right part of the screen, we can see a monitoring tool. Two live plots are depicted. The first one is the output of the predictive maintenance model, while the second is an alert, let's say, notification. The alert notification takes values from zero for normal or normal operation, and one for alert detection. Finally, at the lower right part of the screen is the, let's say, the LXS connector. This connector is triggered when an alert is produced from the ML stack. Then the alert will be stored, will be sent in order to be stored to the Linux SQL database. In the lower left part of the screen, we can see some logs of the ML models during the prediction process. There also, we can notice that the data skipping results provided by the data skipping analytics tool. And in some moment, we can see the highlight that was selected with the mouse and highlighted. Also, we will notice that at the end of January 2018, an alert is produced. And we will also notice at the same time that the LXS connector will be triggered and the alert to be sent to the Linux scale database. So we have to wait some seconds in order to notice the alert here, and also the connector here to send the alert to the Linux scale database. Okay, this is the alert, and now you can see that the connector is triggered. And so that's how we have presented the detection of a possible malfunction during the last date of the January of 2018. And we sent the alert to the Linux scale database. So let's go back to Stathis and the NAOS monitoring platform to see how this alert is being retrieved and handled by the NAOS platform. I'm okay with that.
Good.
I'm sorry, I was muted. So the latest alert that the preventive maintenance algorithm produced was on the 28th of January in 2018. What we will show in the following, in the remaining of this demo, is that we will depict it. We will depict this alert in the monitoring platform, and taking this knowledge of the alert, we will adjust the speeds of the vessel accordingly in order to reduce the load of the main engine and not cause a sudden breakage of the crosshead bearing while the vessel is at sea. So what we need is a map of the scenario, of the remaining scenario, which is the following. The superintendent engineer of the technical department receives an alert, this alert that George talked about in the previous slides. The operator and the captain are also informed about this alert. So the following steps is that the captain exports the current route of the vessel. This is called the ECDIS export. Uploads it to the routing platform and adjusts the route of the vessel to the next port. Once the optimization algorithm runs and the route adjustment is performed, we can see some savings, the reduction of speed, etc. we can see here the monitoring platform where the latest vessel positions are displayed. We can see here on the bell on the top right that there are some alerts for us, which if we visualize them in total, we get to see that indeed for vessel 5 we have a set of alerts. This one on top is on the 28th of January. It was the one that George was describing previously, for which I will optimize the trip past this alert using the routing platform over here. During these days, when Big Data Stack actually started, this vessel was leaving Mumbai on the 29th of January 2018 at 6:40 in the morning to Mundra, calling at the 13th of January 2018, approximately at 9:40. It has a draft of 12.5 meters at fore and 12.5 meters at stern. The minimum speed that we wish the vessel to have is 8 knots, while the maximum speed should not exceed 17 knots. I will upload here the export acting now as the captain. Upload the export of the vessel's route at these days, so I can see here how this route looks like. I can have a look over here on the speeds that the captain intends, that I intend to use, and I will optimize it. Now, the algorithm takes into consideration the minimum and maximum speed that the user imports, and also the weather conditions that are in the route ahead. More or less, it utilizes the sea currents and the weather and the wind to speed up and speed down the vessel when we have favorable currents and wind or not. So over here we can see that indeed the route is optimized. Let me just zoom in a bit so you can have a look from Mumbai to Mundra. And if I hover on the waypoints over here, I can see that indeed the speed is reduced in all waypoints. We can see the speed over ground, SOG, 15.9. This is the intention of the captain, while the optimized speed over ground is 13 knots. The overall fuel savings due to this optimization is 5%. So if we convert this 5% into carbon dioxide emissions and dollars that could be saved, more or less this 5% sums up to 1,240 approximately tons of carbon dioxide. This 5% refers to approximately 12 tons of carbon dioxide less and $1,463. Last but not least, at that moment, Big Data Stack had just started and we didn't have a clue about this malfunction in the main engine. So knowing now, being able to know upfront that there's something happening is something that is invaluable to us. Thank you.